Hey everyone, in this video I'll show you step by step how to determine if the stock is undervalued or overvalued by using the PEG or price to earnings to growth ratio. The PEG ratio that you're seeing on my screen now is a powerful metric that helps investors analyze the price of a stock relative to the company's growth potential. And I've already made videos on my channel on how to value stocks using different formulas such as the dividend discount model, Benjamin Graham's intrinsic value formula, and the PE ratio. So if you haven't seen those videos yet, I'll link them in the description so you can check them out after this one. So without any further ado, let's dive into understanding the PEG ratio. For this video, we'll be analyzing the stocks of Tesla and Nvidia. And I'll be using Google Sheets, but you guys can also follow along in Excel. So first, let's start with the formula. The formula for PEG is very simple. It's the price to earnings ratio divided by the earnings growth rate. And if we expand the formula a bit more, the PE ratio is simply the price per share divided by the earnings per share. And that's exactly why it's called the price to earnings to growth ratio. We'll start with the price, divided by the earnings, and divided by the growth. And then in the end, after we use the formula, we get one single number for the PEG ratio. And then if that number equals one, we will know that the stock is fairly valued according to the formula. However, if the PEG is less than 1, the stock may be undervalued relative to its growth prospects. And lastly, if the PEG is above 1, we will know that the stock may be overvalued. So now that we understand the PEG ratio formula and what to look out for in the PEG number, let's do a quick calculation together. So let's go to this cell first and type ticker. And the first company that we'll be analyzing will be Tesla. So let me type TSLA as the ticker of Tesla. And for the next line, I'll type stock price. And you can get this number from Google Finance or Yahoo Finance website if you're using Excel. But because I'm using Google Sheets, I can do it automatically. I'll type equal sign, Google Finance. For the ticker, I'll select Tesla, comma, and in quotations, I'll type price. Close quotations, close the brackets. And you'll see that the price of Tesla stock is $336.51. And our stock price metric here is exactly the same thing as the price per share. So let me actually rename it to make it simpler. So price per share. So based on our formula, you'll see that the next thing we need to fill out is the earnings per share. So I'll type earnings per share or EPS. And earnings per share, in basic terms, is how much a company is making in profit for each stock that you own as an investor. And you can simply get this number from Yahoo Finance, but I'll use Google Sheets to automatically pull this number as well. So I'll type equal sign, Google Finance function again. I'll select Tesla, comma, and in quotations, I'll type EPS. Close quotations, close the brackets. And I'll see that the trailing 12-month earnings per share for Tesla is $2.04. So now that we have these two numbers, we can actually simplify to make it the PE ratio. So let me type PE ratio. And I'll simply take the price and divide it by the earnings per share. And we'll get the PE ratio for Tesla at 164.96. And now the only metric that's left for us to fill out is the future earnings growth rate for the company. So I'll just type future earnings growth rate. And this is actually the most complicated metric to fill out in our formula because there are multiple different ways to predict the future earnings growth rate. One of the ways is to get the company's historical growth rates and try to forecast the future ones by yourself. And another way is to simply use whatever analysts are forecasting so you don't have to make any calculations on your own. And I actually don't want to forecast the growth rate by myself in this video, so I'll just use Yahoo Finance for simplicity. So in Yahoo Finance, let's type Tesla in the search bar and select the TSLA. Let's scroll down and let's select the analysis. Let's scroll down more. And you'll see the growth estimates, and Tesla is estimated to grow its earnings by 31.56%. So we'll go back to our template and we'll type 31.56 here. So now we should have all the numbers to be able to calculate the PEG ratio, to see whether or not the stock is undervalued or overvalued, and to get the intrinsic value of the stock. So let me just type those three things in the light blue cells here. So we'll start with the PEG ratio, then undervalued or overvalued. And the last one is going to be the intrinsic value or fair value. So now we'll start with the calculation of the PEG ratio. And based on our formula, PEG equals PE divided by the growth rate. So we'll start with an equal sign, select the PE ratio first, which is $164, and divide it by the growth rate of $31. And we'll get the PEG ratio for Tesla at 5.23. And for the next cell, the undervalued or overvalued, we can build a quick if statement to match the rules that are here. And let's ignore the PEG equals 1 in our rule because we don't really need it. So we'll start with an equal sign. We'll type if, select this cell first. So if this cell is greater than 1, the stock is overvalued. So I'll type in quotations overvalued and then comma. And we need to fill out what if the value is false. So if it's less than 1, the stock should be undervalued. So in quotations, I'm going to type undervalued and close quotations. And you see that because the PEG ratio for Tesla is so much higher than 1, the stock is considered to be overvalued based on this formula. So next, let's try to determine the intrinsic value or fair value of the stock. And we know that for the stock to be fairly valued, its PEG should be equal 1. And for the PEG to be equal 1, both its price to earnings ratio and the earnings growth rate should be exactly the same. And for this video, let's assume that the earnings growth rate that we got from Yahoo Finance is accurate. So for Tesla to be at PEG ratio of 1, its PE ratio should have been 31.56 as well. So in the intrinsic value formula, we'll just start with an equal sign. We'll select what the PE ratio should have been, which is 31.56 for Tesla. And we'll multiply it by the earnings per share. And we'll get the fair value of Tesla stock at $64.38. And you'll notice that the Tesla stock price is trading at so much higher than its true fair value based on this formula. So now let's quickly analyze the Nvidia stock to check whether or not its PEG ratio is better than Tesla's. And for that, we'll only need to update two cells in our table, the ticker and the future earnings growth rate. So let me just highlight both of them in yellow color. So for the first one, the ticker, we'll type NVDA as the ticker for Nvidia. And you'll notice that the price per share is now updated for Nvidia at $131.14. The EPS is $2.54. And the PE ratio is 51.63. And according to Yahoo Finance, we can see that the earnings growth rate for Nvidia is forecasted at 50.53%. And based on these numbers, the PEG ratio for Nvidia is 1.02, which is very close to the stock being fairly valued. And the fair value of the stock is at $128.35, which is not too far from its current price. And you can also make a case that maybe the 50% earnings growth rate from Yahoo Finance is very conservative and the real number should be 55%. So if you're more confident in the 55% year-over-year growth, then the PEG ratio for Nvidia becomes less than 1, which makes the stock as undervalued, and the intrinsic or fair value of the stock becomes almost $140 for Nvidia. So now you guys know how to use the PEG formula to determine whether or not the stock is undervalued or overvalued. Just keep in mind that no valuation formula ever is going to be perfect, so make sure to do a detailed research on each company before you decide to invest your hard-earned money. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.